Me and Ed, we are convinced that there's a market for people who want just a bit of adventure without risking life and limb. You know, go into the lake at the weekend, lighten a campfire, none of this bungee jumping or swimming with sharks. So what's the perfect vehicle for this vintage adventure? Well, there are a couple that spring to mind. You've got the Chevy Blazer, that'd be very good. Or the ever popular Jeep Wrangler CJ5. Both of those would be fine. But the real winner for me has to be the instantly recognisable and ever popular compact SUV, the Series 1 Ford Bronco. Prices range from $8,000 to $40,000. Sergio?
Mike.
How you doing, bud?
Good.
Nice to meet you. You must be a realtor.
Why is that?
Because you know how to take a really good picture. It was like going to see a house when they say it's got a very nice big bathroom, but actually when you get there, it was just taken with a wide-angled lens. Yeah. Okay, so tell me about the good stuff. So you've done some work underneath.
I have. I've done some suspension. The brakes have been redone. It was already a good runner when I bought the truck.
Yeah. So let's look at the engine.
Absolutely.
So 302 motor, no leaks?
No, not that I can really tell.
Well, you would know on this driveway because you've got a really clean driveway and there's nothing underneath it, as I can see.
No.
And some good stuff on the inside as well. Original firewall, yes. Slam panel.
Watch
your It's nice and straight round the back, isn't it?
It is, all the parts are there.
And everything is here, yeah. Bumper, yep. Lights, all of that really important stuff is here. So what we got down here? It's suspension work?
Yeah, there's been a four link in there.
There's been a bit of paint done as well. The frame's looking tidy.
There's not much rust underneath the truck that you'll find.
So that's where this truck is good then?
Yes, sir.
Underneath. Look at this, like a museum. Very antiquated. Does everything work in here?
Absolutely not.
I admire your honesty. Right, let me take you for a quick test drive.
It's all yours.
Thank you. Now, most of you people have been thinking, why on earth am I even bothering to test drive this Bronco? Most of the body panels look like they're well beyond any kind of respectable repair. Inside, it's a mess. None of the knobs, switches or dials work. And that transmission, this three on the tree, truthfully would put any potential buyers off. And when it does this, it means, like the rest of the car, it's a little bit tired. But none of that matters, because this is a Bronco, and any body panel or any bit you need for it, you can buy, either through a catalogue or online. Right, now I've pulled onto the dirt, and already I can feel every rock, every boulder, and every bump. Sergio says he's done some work on the suspension and spent some money. I think it needs a little bit of tinkering. Not too expensive to do. Whatever it is, I'm sure it'd be doable. This is what it's all about, getting out here and enjoying the vehicle for what it's good at. And I want to know what's coming up over the brow of this hill, what's round the next bend. And that's the point of being out here in adventure. The brakes are good. I'm going to try reverse. No, I'm actually going to try it. That's not it. That's forward. There you go. Always try reverse on a test drive. It's my recommendation. That's your tip of the day. I need to get this at a much more reasonable price because every single part of this vehicle I stare at is going to need some kind of attention, whether it's the dash, whether it's the doors, the paintwork, the bodywork, the roof. The interior, it all needs work.
It's perfectly vintage, isn't it?
Perfect is not one of the descriptions I would use for this car. It's going to take a lot of work to pull it back together. You want $12,000 for it?
Correct.
I'll give you $8,000 for it.
I can't do it. That's what I put into it.
It's a good car. We know it's rare. Great. We know it's desirable. We know it's what the market wants. But this car is going to suck money like you can't believe. You know, even if you said 8.5, I'm just not even going to bother. Okay. I'll take the risk. What do you reckon?
Okay, you're right.
Yes? You're going to have a deal with me.
Deal.
I've just bought myself a full Bronco. Ed is going to kill me when he sees this.